Hello, welcome to the second of the 8-part video series on how to create a mushroom house. Today we will go through the various brush tools to create and paint a small mushroom. At the end of this video, you'll be able to start creating your own models and paint them using the color palette. Use the video chapters to rewatch parts of the video. Let's begin. First, we need to create a new file. If you're in the gallery, you can press the plus sign or go to the file menu and select new file. In my case, I will press the plus sign and select the smaller plus sign to create an empty scene. When we create a new file like this, we are automatically in object mode to create our model. Let's start with the freehand tool. Select the freehand icon in the bottom left corner and the create pencil tool to start drawing voxels continuously. We can quickly select another color in the lower left corner and draw a new stroke. One of my favorite features is the Adjust Last Edit tool to manipulate the created stroke afterwards. By default, it will adjust the whole stroke. If we uncheck all control points, we can select the beginning and end point by tapping with the pencil. Selecting the middle point of the stroke allows us to adjust this section too. Aside from moving, we can also use scaling to adjust our stroke. Try it out! Instead of creating, let's remove some voxels by using the erase tool while in freehand mode. After removing some individual voxels, we can also remove the whole model by double tapping on it. This only deletes the voxels that are attached to the model. Next, we use the single mode to draw individual voxels. Select it by tapping the icon to cycle through the tools or hold your pencil to select it from the menu. If you hold the pencil when moving around, we can place the drawn voxels more easily. By adjusting the brush size slider to about 6 voxels, we can draw more at once. Hold the pencil again and create a cube of voxels. If we use the resize last edit again, we can place it above the grid. Another cool feature is that we can change the shape while in resize last edit mode. In the bottom left corner, change the brush to spheric instead of cubic, and tap the white circle. The same applies to the brush size. This offers greater flexibility in general when working. For now, we'll skip the stencil mode and try the linear drawing mode. With this tool, we can draw straight lines and use the Move Last Edit functionality to adjust. The perpendicular mode can be useful to draw a line in one direction only. Personally, I don't use this tool frequently and instead use the combination of the default linear mode that we used previously and the Move Last Edit. It really depends on your preference, of course. My next and probably favorite tool is the box mode. With it, we can quickly build larger models and also offering the most brush shapes. With the brush size of 3, go into top view and use the grid to create an evenly spaced area of voxels using the cubic brush. Because of the brush size, we add a bevel to the square we have created. Changing the brush size smooths the shape to be more organic. By setting the brush size back to 1 and tapping the white circle, we have a square again. Selecting a different brush type will change the shape after tapping the white circle. We can also add depth by scaling on the z-axis, or the blue rectangle of the gizmo. For clarity, set your brush size back to 1 and choose the prism shape. The shape is aligned based on the view. For example, go into top view and tap the white circle again to align the prism on the z-axis. Now we have a roof. Play around with the shapes on different axes. Like the spheric brush, we also have the hollow spheric brush. Or the bounding box brush. Again, by changing the brush size, we can influence the thickness of the edges. Next is the adjacent and adjacent diagonal tools. But first, try to copy this particular setup using the box mode, where the voxels touch diagonally. In this particular setup, the adjacent mode allows us to add or remove voxels based on surface area. The adjacent diagonal mode will also extrude the other planes. Use this tool to quickly adjust larger surfaces at once. Nice, now you know the most important tools to create voxel models. Let's combine what we know so far and create our own model together. Make sure to delete all the voxels and tap the color palette icon in the bottom left. Go to the third tab where we will use the colors we need to create a mushroom. Select the box mode and make sure the create tool is activated. We first start creating the stem using a gradation of colors. Draw four voxels at the center and adjust the scale to add more along the z-axis. Go over the color palette and select multiple colors by holding the pencil on the first color and dragging the pencil down. Let's change the color of the voxels on top and adjust it so that it influences the whole stem. By going into top view and tapping the white circle, we apply the colors from the top to the bottom. As you can see, the stem has a gradient of colors. You can change this by tapping the white circle again. Once you're satisfied, you can select the create icon again to confirm. Let's create the mushroom cap. We need a nice red color, or one you prefer. In my case, I would like to change to red color. We can do this by changing the hue, saturation, and brightness. Once I'm satisfied, I will select the colors I want to apply and tap the gradient option. This will create a gradient based on the first color and applies it to the last selected. While still in box mode with a spheric brush, go into top view and drag the base of the mushroom cap. Adjust the position and size to be above the stem. Scale the cap to the size of your liking. Make sure it is symmetrical in this case. In the top right corner, there's the option to enable mirror mode to maintain symmetry. Select the X and Y axis and remove or add voxels you like. I would like to add more colors to the cap. Go into paint mode and select a higher, more saturated color. Adjust the influence by using the scale last edit mode. The only thing missing are the dots. Tap on one of the high value colors used for the stem. That's it, the mushroom is complete. Thank you for sticking around. Have fun and experiment with shapes and colors. In the next video, we will cover more advanced ways to adjust and paint our models. See you in the next video.